I really hope you're finding these integration by substitution videos helpful to you. So here's yet another one. I'm going to start off by saying let's let u, our variable for substitution, be equal to what's inside of the square root here. In this case, it's the x squared minus 81. You're going to see why I'm picking on that in just a second here. All right. So if u is equal to x squared minus 81, then what's the derivative of u with respect to x? Well, the derivative of x squared is just a 2x, and the derivative of negative 81, that's just a constant, is 0. All right, let's do one more thing. Let's get this du up here by itself, and so I'm going to multiply both sides by dx, I hope you see. Right? If we multiply both sides by dx, these guys cancel out, and I'm left with du is equal to 2x dx. But there's one more thing I'm going to do, because if I look at the original problem, I see an x dx, but I don't see a 2x dx. So let's rearrange this right-hand side so that it looks just like and only like x dx, like what I've got here. And that means I need to divide this entire right-hand side and the other side by 2. Right, so I'm going to do one more little bit of trickery here. I'm going to divide both sides entirely by 2, and that knocks out these 2's on the right-hand side, leaving the right-hand side as x dx. Okay, and that's exactly what I wanted. I wanted an x dx because I see that in the original problem. Which then means that I'm going to replace x dx with this thing here, but if it's okay with you, I'm going to write it a little differently. I'm going to write it as 1 half times du. Okay, I could write it as du over 2, but I'm going to write it as 1 half du. Okay, so I've got this. Let me put it in a little box here. I like to usually box these guys off here. Kind of reminds me of what I'm substituting back in. Okay, so I've got in place of u, I've got an x squared minus 81, or in place of x squared minus 81, I've got a u. Maybe I should say it that way. And in place of x dx, I'm going to put in a 1 half du. All right, so let's rewrite our original problem now with these variables or the substitution going on here. Okay, so I've got it going from 9 up to 41. And check this out, right? In place of x squared minus 81, I'm putting in the letter u, so I've got the square root of u. And in place of, let's see if I can do this in red. Maybe I'll circle it for you in red. In place of x dx, right, in place of x dx, I'm going to substitute in this 1 half du, right? But I'm going to do it this way. I'm going to put the 1 half here in front of my square root, and I'm going to put the du after my square root. Doesn't really matter. It's all being multiplied together anyways. But I'm writing it that way because I hope you see that I have a constant multiple of 1 half in this integrand, and if you haven't learned it by now, you can take any constant outside of an integral symbol just like this. Right? You can write it like this. 1 half from 9 up to 41 of u, right, the square root of u, du. But watch how I'm going to write the square root of u. I'm going to write it this way. Right? I'm writing it that way on purpose. Okay, so I just moved the constant of 1 half, constant multiple of 1 half, outside of my integrand symbol, integral symbol there. And now I'm going to take and find the antiderivative of u to the 1 half. That is, I'm going to add 1, right, add 1. I'm writing it as 2 over 2, which is a 3 halves. And then that new exponent moves to the denominator as well. Okay, so here's what I have so far. I have, don't forget our 1 half that's out front, right, times u to the 3 halves, u to the 3 halves, there it is, u to the 3 halves, over 3 halves. But since we don't divide fractions, we flip and multiply them, then I'm going to flip this 3 halves, right, I'm going to flip it and multiply it, so it flips as 2 thirds, I hope you see. Okay. And hey, look at this 2 and this 2. These guys completely cancel each other out. They're out of here. So I really then have u to the 3 halves all over 3, and that is being evaluated between 9 and 41. Except that there's one problem with this. Yeah, I hope you see it. Look, this is in terms of u, but the original problem wanted the integral in terms of x. So I need to take this x squared minus 81 and put it back in place of u. All right, I can do that. In fact, I'm running out of room, so I'm going to do that on the next side here, okay? In place of u, I'm going to put in the x squared minus 81. So here's what I've got. I've got x squared minus 81 raised to the 3 halves all over 3 being evaluated between 9 and 41. Okay, that's looking a little bit better. The fundamental theorem of calculus says everywhere I see an x, I'm going to substitute in 41, right? Whatever that quantity comes out to be, minus everywhere I see an x, I'm going to substitute in my lower limit of 9. All right, so I'm going to do it this way. All right, I've got 41 squared minus 81, and all of that is being raised to the 3 halves, all over 3, right? This whole thing is over 3. So there, all I did was I substituted in place of x, I substituted in that upper limit of 41, minus, and now in place of x, I'm going to put in the lower limit of 9, so that's 9 squared minus 81 quantity raised to the 3 halves, all over 3. Well, I hope you see, although it looks kind of nasty, it's not really not that bad, because look, let's do this one first. This is easy. 9 squared is 81, and 81 minus 81 is a 0, and 0 raised to whatever is still a 0, and divided by 3 is still a 0. So this whole second term really just kind of wipes out, just turns into a 0, right? Minus 0 isn't going to change our answer. So let's go work on this part. Let's see, 41 squared, if you do that on your calculator, you'll see 41 squared is 1681, right, minus 81, right, and then that quantity raised to the 3 halves all over 3. Well, let's see, 1681 minus 81 obviously is just 1600, right? Yeah, so I've got just a 1600 here, and 1600, how about we do this? Let's write 1600 as just the square root. I'm just going to handle this 2 in the denominator here. This is really the square root of 1600 is what it really means to me. And the square root of 1600 is 40. Right? Is 40. And then I'm going to take that 40 and I'm going to raise it to the third power. So 40 times 40 times 40. Hey, 40 times 40 times 40 is simply, 64,000. So there is my final answer, 64,000 all over 3. Hope that helps.